Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and have the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday the 17th of June. US NSA Sullivan meets Indian counterpart Doval and Jaishankar in New Delhi. Pakistan's tax-heavy budget fuels public anger. And Muslims across South Asia celebrate Eid al-Adha. And now for all the details, the US National Security Advisor Jake Sullivan, who is on a two-day visit to India for the second meeting of the Initiative on Critical and Emerging Technologies, began his visit by meeting his Indian counterpart Ajit Doval. They both had consultations on bilateral, regional and global issues. The two NSAs have driven a concerted effort to engage in identified areas of collaboration in diverse domains of new and emerging technologies, including semiconductors, artificial intelligence, quantum computing, defense innovation, space and advanced telecommunications. Later on, Sullivan also met India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar, who expressed confidence that strategic partnership between India and the US will continue to advance strongly in the near term. It is the first visit of a high-ranking official from a major power since PM Modi assumed office for a third consecutive term. Sullivan is also expected to call on Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Moving on, at least 13 people were killed and dozens injured on Monday after passenger train Kanchenjunga Express was hit from behind by a goods train in India's West Bengal. Three coaches of the passenger train were derailed in the crash. Indian Prime Minister, in a post on X, expressed his condolences and announced a compensation for the families of the deceased and injured. State Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee also expressed concern over the incident. Railway Minister Ashwini Vaishnav also rushed to the site to review the situation. The incident comes a year after India's state-run railway system suffered its worst crash in two decades in the state of Orissa, where nearly 300 people were killed. The death toll was likely to rise. Security forces on Monday neutralized a terrorist in Bandipora district of India's Jammu and Kashmir territory. The joint operation was launched based on intelligence input of presence of terrorists in the region. A cordon and search operation was still underway till the last reports came in. This comes a day after Home Minister Amit Shah held a review meeting in New Delhi over the security situation in Jammu and Kashmir. In the five-hour-long meeting, which had JNK Lieutenant Governor Manoj Sinha, NSA Ajit Doval, Army Chief General Manoj Pandey and heads of security agencies in attendance, Shah directed them to work in a mission mode and ensure quick response in a coordinated manner. Highlighting recent terror incidents, the Home Minister said they show that terrorism has been forced to shrink from highly organized acts of terrorist violence to a mere proxy war. "We are determined to root it out as well," he said. And Pakistan's plan to raise taxes in its recent budget is likely to help it win an IMF bailout, but the move has fueled public anger. A report.
Pakistan's plan to raise taxes in its latest budget and boost state revenues is likely to win it approval for an IMF loan to stave off another economic meltdown, but has fueled public anger. Experts have said the South Asian country has set a challenging tax revenue target of 13 trillion Pakistani rupees for the year starting July 1, a near 40% jump. But citizens in major cities have expressed dismay and anger as they expected some relief. But their woes are going to rise further.
हम माचिस के डिब्बे पे भी जो है वो आपको टैक्स दे रहे हैं हमारे टैक्स से आप लोग चल रहे हैं सारी गवर्नमेंट हमारे टैक्स पे चल रही है और हम टैक्स देकर भी जो है वो इतने लाचार इतने बेबस हैं कि हम अपनी जिंदगियां खुद को कुर्बान करने पे लगा रहे हैं
द बिग राइज इन द टैक्स टारगेट इज मेड अप ऑफ अ 48% इंक्रीज इन डायरेक्ट टैक्सेस एंड 35% हाइक इन इनडायरेक्ट टैक्सेस नॉन टैक्स रेवेन्यू including petroleum levies, is seen increasing by a whopping 64%.
ये आवाम दोस्त बजट बिल्कुल भी नहीं इसको कहा जा सकता, क्योंकि उसकी वजूहत ये हैं कि आप ये देख सकते हैं जो हम जैसे जो तनख्वाहदार जो तबका है उसके ऊपर मजीद जो है टैक्सेस का बोझ डाल दिया गया है। ऑलरेडी पहले से ही इतने सारे टैक्सेस हमारे ऊपर हैं जिसके अंदर आप ये देखें ना, आप गरीब आदमी या तनख्वाहदार तबका जो है वो किस तरीके से गुजारा करेगा, ठीक है ना। अभी जो है बिजली के बिल, गैस के बिल, उसके साथ साथ दीगर मुख्तलिफ जो है टैक्सेस जो है डायरेक्ट इनडायरेक्ट हम पे जो है वो लागू किए गए हैं, हम उसके बोझ तले जो है दबते जा रहे हैं और ये मजीद टैक्सेस पे टैक्सेस लगाकर मजीद जो है ना आवाम को जो है खुदकुशी पर जो है मजबूर किया जा रहा है कि वो खुदकुशी करके मर जाए।
मीनवाइल कंसर्न्स रिमेन अबाउट द गवर्नमेंट्स एबिलिटी टू परस्यू रिफॉर्म सिंस इट इज वल्नरेबल टू द क्वर्क्स ऑफ कोएलिशन पॉलिटिक्स इन द फेस ऑफ राइजिंग पब्लिक प्रेशर अगेंस्ट इन्फ्लेशनरी रिफॉर्म मेजर्स। Reports suggest that the ally of PM Shehbaz Sharif's government, the Pakistan People's Party, was not happy with some of the measures taken in the budget. Sharif's government is also faced with the continued popularity of jailed former PM Imran Khan, whose party lawmakers held protests as the budget was being presented.
As Germany is in talks with Uzbekistan to enable deportations of Afghan citizens, Taliban spokesman Zabihullah Mujahid has said that recent actions by some Afghan citizens should not result in the deportation of other migrants. Mujahid said personal matters should not be applied to everyone. The development comes as three Afghan citizens were killed and some were arrested in Germany for crimes involving knife attacks. The attacks have sparked widespread reactions in Germany, and several political figures, including the German Chancellor, have called for the deportation of Afghan migrants. Germany had stopped deportations to Afghanistan after the Taliban took power in 2021. Sri Lankan President Ranil Wickremesinghe said on Sunday that the feasibility study on a proposal to establish land connectivity with India is in its final stages. This proposal and the prospect of a power grid connection between the two nations are likely to be discussed during the upcoming visit of India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar, local media reported. Wickremesinghe said a commercial venture to sell the excess renewable energy to India would also be discussed. On Saturday, the Sri Lankan Foreign Ministry announced that Jaishankar would arrive in Colombo around 20th of June. However, there is no official confirmation from the Indian side so far. Muslims across India and Pakistan on Monday celebrated Eid al-Adha by offering mass prayers and sacrificing animals on the occasion. One of Islam's two main festivals, it also marks the climax of the annual Hajj pilgrimage. Take a look.
Muslims across India on Monday observed the festival of Eid al-Adha by offering prayers and sacrifices. Thousands of devout Muslims were seen reciting the Namaz prayers at the Mughal-era Jama Masjid in New Delhi and the iconic Taj Mahal in Agra. Similar scenes were witnessed across the country, where devotees joined the vibrant celebrations on the holy occasion. Eid al-Adha is one of Islam's two main holidays and also marks the culmination of the annual Hajj pilgrimage.
और ये याद दिलाती है इब्राहिम अलैहिस्सलाम और इस्माइल अलैहिस्सलाम की कुर्बानी के बारे में।
बेशक
कुर्बानी जो है वो ये नहीं कि भाई हमें क्या कुर्बानी करनी है, जानवर की कुर्बानी है, बकरे की कुर्बानी है, नहीं, बल्कि कुर्बानी ये है कि हम अपनी ज़िंदगी से सारी बुराइयों को कुर्बान कर दें और इंसानियत को ऐसा पैगाम दें कि सारे इंसान जो है इंसान बन के ज़िंदगी गुजारें।
सिमिलर सीन्स वर विटनेस्ड इन नेबरिंग पाकिस्तान, वेयर मिलियंस ऑफ मुस्लिम्स मार्क द फेस्टिवल विद स्पेशल प्रेयर्स. Despite skyrocketing inflation, people also slaughtered livestock, including goats, bulls and even camels to mark the occasion. Known as the Festival of Sacrifice, on Eid al-Adha, Muslims around the world slaughter animals such as cattle and goats as they mark the willingness of Ibrahim to sacrifice his son on God's command. The meat is divided into portions and shared among family, friends and donated to the poor.
Alhamdulillah, har saal ki tarah is saal bhi hum sunnat e ibrahim ka farz ada karne ja rahe hain aur ye jo qurbani hai asal qurbani jab hi kehlayegi jab hum is qurbani ka gosht jo hai wo sahi mustahiqin aur gareeb logon mein pahuncha sake aur unhe taqseem kar sake jo pura saal gosht nahi kha sakte.
That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. ब्रेकिंग न्यूज एंड व्यूज फ्रॉम इंडिया।